For thousands of years, humanity has wrestled with the idea that we may not be alone in our solar system. Speculation that aliens might exist dates back to philosophers in ancient Greece. But it was the middle of the 20th century when people's imaginations really began to run riot. Suddenly, little green men were everywhere in popular culture. Although the use of the phrase is believed to have originated in 1908, it was between the 1920s and 50s that green Martian characters were plastered all over the covers of science fiction magazines and later people's TVs. The reality is that if extraterrestrial life does exist in our solar system, it will be perhaps hidden in Venus clouds, beneath Mars' surface, or in the vast underground oceans of one of Saturn's icy moons. But where else is the best bet for finding it? Our moon. If NASA planning remains on the rails politically, technically, and financially, the United States will plant new footprints on the moon toward the end of 2025. NASA is now suggesting that our future visitors to the lunar South Pole region should be on the lookout for extraterrestrial life in supercold, permanently shadowed craters of the moon, which is a huge deal. The moon has been a favorite amongst alien enthusiasts since the Apollo missions, and the theories have only been increasing in numbers ever since.
Orbit. Beyond the blue.
The dark side of the moon has played a major role in these theories. But are they really just theories? Recently, NASA's Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter made a shocking discovery of something that looked like a giant alien lunar base or ancient alien city that lies on the dark side of the moon. As outrageous as that sounds, stay with us here. Take a look at this image. Scott Waring, a self-proclaimed UFO expert who witnessed the image, speculated about the strange structure being a giant alien city on the moon's surface through his blog. He said, "I have found an alien structure over 9 miles long on the moon's Mares crater." He zoomed into the moon anomaly to focus on its grainy, indistinct details. He said, "You can see there is a structure here, and it does appear to be a solid object." He examined the image using 2 different filters supplied by the Google Moon app and found that the mystery object vanishes when both visible imagery and color is terrain are applied. Waring, who has expressed doubts about NASA's knowledge of life on the moon, believes this is further proof of a cover-up by the US space agency. Considering NASA is now saying there may be life on the moon after all, it doesn't seem like such a far-fetched accusation anymore. Prabal Saxena, a planetary researcher at NASA's Goddard, has suggested that microbial life could potentially survive in the harsh conditions near the lunar South Pole. The lunar South Pole has long been believed to harbor properties that can enable survival and even growth of life. Conspiracy theories about aliens on the moon started floating around since time immemorial. One of the most popular ones is that Buzz Aldrin saw an alien ship of some kind during the Apollo 11 ride, and that he's been covering it up and hiding that he's actually a UFO believer. To be fair, Aldrin did once allude to there being an unknown something tracing their path to the moon.
"We were smart enough to not say, Houston, there's a light out there that's following us." So technically, it becomes an unidentified flying object.
Some also believe that Neil Armstrong saw a fleet of UFOs on the moon. During the Apollo 11 mission in 1969, after Armstrong landed on the moon, NASA claims to have lost transmission for roughly 2 minutes. And in reportedly a secret message to NASA, he said, "These babies were huge, sir. Enormous. You wouldn't believe it. I'm telling you, there are other spacecrafts out here, lined up on the far side of the crater's edge. They are on the moon watching us." Of course, he never directly confirmed or denied it, and he mostly remained a private person throughout the rest of his lifetime. Did he actually see something he wasn't supposed to see and hence remain silent throughout the rest of his career and lifetime? The scientists conducting the NASA study believe that the surface of the moon is ancient and unchanging. Evidence of any impacts or existing artifacts will be preserved for between millions and billions of years. During the Apollo 10 mission, a test run for the first mission to the moon, astronauts, among other things, took to testing various equipment. The stakes were high, since this was not a simulation, but real space. Much to the surprise of these astronauts, they heard a strange sort of whistling on their headphones that they later described as space music. Later, another NASA astronaut, Alan Bean, claimed he saw something shiny on the moon. He described it as shoe leather. While you expect space to be black and devoid of light in places, what was this shiny thing he saw? Could it have been glass? Whatever the reason for what he saw, there's not much of an explanation for this one. Is there some hidden truth behind these theories? Just imagine an alien craft coming to Earth and then going back dejected because we were too busy doing other things than to notice them. What if there are telltale signs of such a visit? Not on Earth, but on the Moon. A double crater formed due to the crash of a mystery spacecraft has piqued scientific interest. This crater has been found on the Moon. The eastern crater measures 18 meters across, and a western crater measures 16 meters across. Scientists expected a crater to be formed, as they knew an unknown piece of space junk crashed into the moon last year. But here's the thing, no other previous crash of any space junk has formed twin craters like this one. NASA has said that the double crater was unexpected. The double crater was unexpected, and may indicate that the rocket body had large masses at each end. Typically, a spent rocket has mass concentrated at the motor end. The rest of the rocket stage mainly consists of an empty fuel tank. Since the origin of the rocket body remains uncertain, the double nature of the crater may indicate its identity. So is there a possibility of an alien brooding on the moon because their spacecraft crashed? In other news, researchers in 2014 discovered something massive lurking underneath the far side of the moon, what they termed as a mysterious blob. Imagine taking a pile of metal five times larger than the Big Island of Hawaii and burying it underground. That's roughly how much unexpected mass was detected. The mysterious structure sits at least 180 miles beneath the South Pole Aitken Basin, a colossal crater punched into the lunar landscape billions of years ago, when the moon's initially molten surface had cooled just enough for such impacts to leave a lasting mark. While we can't set out on a quest to understand the origins of this chunk of mass, take a look at this image. This false color image shows the topography on the far side of the moon, with highs in warm colors and lows in cool colors. A dashed circle indicates the zone of the excess dense mass under the South Pole Aitken Basin. Strange, right? The South Pole Aitken crater is the biggest preserved impact crater that we know of in the solar system. It's almost 10 times the size of the Chicxulub crater, which was created by the meteor that wiped out the dinosaurs. This moon crater is massive. And now, the discovery of this odd mass only adds to the curiosity, especially since this crater and the nearby lunar South Pole are major potential targets for multiple future missions to the moon. And scientists are already extremely eager to study the mass. Though the South Pole Aitken Basin is incredibly vast, it can't be seen from Earth because it is on the far side of the moon, which faces away from us at all times. Instead, it was examined by a NASA spacecraft that sent back info on the small changes in gravity around the moon that were being caused by this massive object. The Grail mission's duo of spacecraft dubbed Deb and Flo orbited the moon for nearly a year, precisely charting variations in the lunar gravitational field. Using this, the Grail team constructed the highest resolution gravity map of our little lunar companion yet, which led to the reveal of the mystery mass. So let's get to the question. What is this mass? What is resting under the far side of the moon? What secrets does the moon actually hold? the team suggests two possibilities to explain the subsurface mass. One of the explanations of this extra mass is that the metal from the asteroid that formed this crater is still embedded in the moon's mantle. Scientists simulated a possible collision with an asteroid on a computer and found that some kinds of metal could settle into the layer between the crust and the core, where this chunk is still sitting. But they've maintained that only a more in-depth analysis will tell what it really is. Like we mentioned earlier, UFO conspiracies have been active and alive ever since the first Apollo missions. Especially since the world's two most famous astronauts, Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin, have both allegedly claimed that UFOs were spotted as they headed to the moon. Neither of the men made any comment about aliens, just allegedly that some objects had been unidentified during their mission, and Armstrong's claims were made via second-hand information. But that much was enough to encourage decades of speculation about aliens on the moon. The moon is the only world besides Earth ever visited by humans. By studying the moon, scientists can piece together Earth's origin story, and perhaps maybe even find proof of existence of the third kind. Maybe that's just wishful thinking. But nonetheless, there's so much we still don't understand about our natural satellite, which makes this a huge area for research that will benefit space research and future exploration. With Artemis, we will get a step closer to knowing our moon a little bit better, but what do I know?
Orbit. Beyond the blue.